Development is the year, today is the 2014, the year of the electric evangelist. Okay, I give you this one. I don't know if they're still in, but you can just replace in case. You know, so God wrote love letter in order to communicate to his beloved children. And that was written by his own finger. God is the first publisher, you know? So publishing ministry is in the plan of God. You are not here by accident, I would say, and believe that you are here by God's plan and purpose. Amen. God's design. So if you are here by accident, let us change the item. You are here according to God's plan. So, thank you so much. This is the first Congress. There was a meeting before, but not a Congress. That was only a mini, you know, meeting. But thank you very much. So the question this afternoon, by the way, I'd like to appreciate also the very strong support of the union leadership, Director Palaya. Because this Sally program in the university around our division is a union program. Union program. The Central Luzon Conference, other missions and conferences are part, but the union is the direct institution who will supervise this program. So the question for us today, young people, is what is God's plan for you in this coming vacation? Right? That's a good question. What is His plan for you? But if you reverse the question, is what is your plan? That's a good question. What is your plan for God this coming summer? So, student literature evangelism is more than just a work. Because it is really a work, but it is more than just a work. Some are working in the cafeteria, working in the department. That's a work. But being a student ILLI is more than a work. Why? There is a specific reason. You know, our vacation could be spent in many ways, right? You can enjoy, because it's vacation time, you go home and be with your loved ones, look at entertainment, sleep, eat, sleep, and be entertained. You can do that. But there is God's plan to use our vacation to save souls, right? So is it a vacation to save ourselves or a vacation to save souls? That's another question, right? So may I share with you what the Bible says in Matthew 16:54, for whosoever will save his life shall lose it, and whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it. Shall we pray? Loving Father, I am inspired to see this group of students here in Adventist University of the Philippines, that you have called them for a purpose. It is within your plan that when school closes, there will be a great opportunity for our young people to go as literary evangelists. Father, we pray that thou wilt bless us today in this Congress. We thank you for the support of the administration, and I pray for the outpouring of the Spirit to help us realize the importance of your calling for us, and that we can respond positively into this ministry, so that many souls who are hopeless in Jesus Christ will be given the last warning message of salvation before it's too late. Thank you for hearing our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so that's our tendency as a human being, you know, to stay in our comfort zone, right? Especially during summer vacation. Comfort zone. But this is the message from the Lord. It's opposite. If you want a comfort zone, go to the zone of the Lord, right? All right, it says here there are four at least important benefits or objectives why there is a literature, student literature ministry in the Seventh-day Adventist Church. Every year, there are at least more than 15,000 students all over the world who are joining every summer vacation all over the world. The biggest is from South America, like Brazil, Monte Morelos in Inter-America. Out of these 15,000 students joining this ministry every summer, in our division is ESSD, Southern Asia Pacific Division, that's covering 14 countries. We have at least more than 2,000 students. 2,000 students. Now, why we have a student lecture ministry program in the church? Why? At least to summarize this, these four things are very vital and important. One is witnessing. Every Adventist member is a missionary. If you are not a missionary, therefore you are a mission field. Right? Two things only. Either you are a missionary or a mission field. And we know you are in this university, you've been hearing messages, sermons every day and every Sabbath that we are witnesses of God. Whether you are still students or a degree holder, we are witnesses for God, for His great love, for mankind. So when you go out, first you think. Don't think first of scholarship. Don't think of money. It will just come. It will come. Because if we only follow the formula of God in Matthew 6:33, the problem if we invert that, as long as we follow the formula, seek ye first the kingdom of God, you know the text, and all the money, the tuition fees, the shoes, the stockings will be added unto us. But if you go out this coming summer, oh, I would like to buy a new dress, Lord. This is good, but not the right formula. You know? Witnessing. First of all, you have there to witness for God. And then, giving service to the people. You know, you are very powerful, students, young people, when you go out there for service, not to get something, but to give something. When you knock at the door, when you press the doorbell, think that you are there to bring the message, the knowledge of salvation, to bring the service to the people. Because when you serve the people, they will serve you. I tell you, when they see young people and they are very earnest in their presentation, sometimes they will say, oh, I have all the books already, but I give you 1,000 pesos because I like you. Instead of sleeping at home, you are helping your parents. Because they are touched because of the spirit of service you are doing. You know? And that is Jesus Christ. The life of Jesus, I came here not to be served, but to serve. You see? So, service. When you become a student leader evangelist, you are there for service. And you know, another plan why we have in the church this program is a part of your training. Whatever your course, whether you are taking nursing, technology, theology, psychology, all the G's, still you need a training. Because when you go out after graduation, you'll be sent to Africa, not the Ebola infested area. On next week, I'm going to Uganda, that is East Central Africa, that's quite far from the West. I was distinct, supposed to go to West, Nigeria, like, but they said, oh, sorry, we have to postpone the meeting because of Ebola. So now the direction is to go to Uganda. Wherever you go, you need the training, you know. There are many things, young people, that you will learn from the field, which you will learn from the classroom. I tell you, these are all theories in the classroom. You have competent professors and teachers, but the most competent teacher is the Holy Spirit and the teacher, Jesus Christ. And you are going to learn many things that will prepare you for greater service when you are out in the field as a student literature evangelist. You see? Training. Now, so I'd like to tell you that the student program of our church is not a very, shall I say, profitable. When I say not profitable, in terms of the department, only Sometimes it's break even. You mean I mean the sales of the students and the funds that will go to the department, publishing department. But the expenses involved, like in Mountain View, in the Central Philippines, from Mountain View, the flight to Bacolod, the flight to Cebu, they are not taking boats now, they are flying their place already, Cebu Pacific. Because many times the fare is lower than the boat, you know, because of promotional fare. Sometimes the expenses involved, given by the department, because that's the policy. Is somebody giving the policy, a lecture of policy, maybe on Sunday? You still have to give the policy that the students, when they are assigned, if you go to Baguio, if you choose Baguio, then the department and the publishing house will pay for your fare going to Baguio and in coming back. You see? And that's already an investment. Before you knock at the door, the department is already spent for you. Because it's a part of training. According to the spirit of prophecy, we have to train our young people. Now, among the college and university students, at least we expect more. But some are joining from the elementary department, some from the high school. Inexperienced. And yet, because it is a program of training, we have to do this. I mean, the church is not getting profit very much. Sometimes break even, sometimes it's even losing. We have more expenses than income to the department. But because of the concept of training, we have to follow this program. But of course, the way I look at you, we will be profiting much. As I look at your smile and your perspective, I know that God says we only help. Next time I will present to you, maybe tomorrow afternoon or Sunday, that it's not we who are selling. I tell you, God sells, we only help. Because many times the student leave by the Lord today, I'm going to sell. Please help me. Lord, that's a wrong prayer. Lord, today I'm going out. I'm a student from AUP. I'm working at the fault of Mayan Volcano in Legazpi. Are you going there? Lord, you are going to sell. I am going to help you. And I'm going to do my best to help you. You know, when God sells, people cannot refuse. I was in Mongolia a few months ago. Wow, you know, it's very challenging area to work in a Buddhist country like Mongolia. It's not our division territory, but I was requested to go there to make a seminar for 1 week. The Buddhists there have a negative connotation of Christians. You know, there are 3 million people in Mongolia. How many of you have visited Mongolia? You know, this between Russia and China, Mongolia is in the middle. At first, I have a very negative connotation of Mongolia. Because when I was in elementary, I heard, of course, we have the pencil that is Mongol. The special pencil is Mongol. So that's positive. But when people said, oh, when they see a person who is abnormal, it's Mongoloid. Why is it called Mongoloid? That means people in Mongolia are not normal. But you know, when I went there, no, it's different. Mongolia is a very big continent, maybe 20 times the Philippines. But Philippines has 100 million people. Mongolia has only more than 3 million people. And thank God, we have at least 2,070 Adventists. 2,070 Adventists, members of the church. That was started only 14 years ago. 14 years ago, ang pagsimula ng Adventista. Tayo ay more than 100 years sa Pilipinas. Eh, wala silang karanasan tungkol sa literature ministry. We started, but you know, it's very challenging. There was no proper training. And the publishing ministry was started 4 years ago. Only 4 years ago. So, ang perception ng mga Buddhist sa mga Christian, sira ang ulo. Oh, these people are, you know, crazy. Mongoloid. You see, so when you approach the house and you know that you're a Christian, they are very negative. But you know, I told them in the seminar, no, that's not our problem, that is God's problem. Because God says we only help. You help to carry the book. You help to knock, visit and knock at the door and smile and present the book and make the presentation. All right. So, that's a training. But tomorrow I'll continue the story, the miracles there in Mongolia. Training program. Training. And then, what we are looking for mostly is number four. And God knows. Because no money, no money. You see? So God knows that we need finances. We need tuition fees allowances that can help our studies, help also our merits. So these four are basic objectives of why there's a literature ministry in the Seventh-day Adventist Church. But first, let us do it according to the number. Okay? Seek you first. You see, in 2 Timothy 2:15, we have to study. So, we are studying for service. Whatever your course, you remember, after this, you are going to serve where you'll be assigned. So, you are studying for service. Study to show thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So, you are studying at the same time, you are preparing for service. And according to Proverbs 22:6, train up the students. Train up. Because you are still a child in learning. You need training. But when you graduate, then you are not a child anymore. You become an adult to face the challenges of the world today. So, we have to be trained according to the way of the Lord. And yes, this is, I told you a while ago, but we have this year, a share of 2,000 students throughout the world. For example, here in this division, these are the number of students. I think last year, we have 16 from Bangladesh, Myanmar, I think this 2 years ago. But last year, we have more in Thailand. The student program in Thailand was very successful now. Okay, of course, my Philippines. Wow. And almost 1,000 of this, at least 800 to 900 of this in the Philippines are from our Mountain View College. There are 28 groups every summer vacation scattered to Visayas and Mindanao. And they are migrating even to North Philippines for the past 2 years. But Sir Matirai said, not this time. Close the door. Am I right? Why? He said, his administrator and the administrator of the union, he said, no, this time we will not allow them to come. Why? It sounds selfishness. But there is a good reason. Because he said, we have good potential students of AUP. Like that. Because if we only stop the program of Mountain View people to come here without another reason, I would be disappointed. I'd be disappointed. But because he has a good reason, he said, what are we doing with our students here at AUP? Why people from the south and the sides will come when we have good students here at AUP? And that's a good question. And that's a good challenge. I baptized MVC. You know, MVC, when they started the college more than 60 years ago, MVC means mais versus kamote. Because they were very poor at the start. At the start, the students were eating kamote tops. They eat the kamote, and their bayan is kamote tops. So, and then sometimes they eat, instead of rice, there was no rice, it's corn, so mais versus kamote. Not patio versus adhere, etc. But today, I baptized them more than 10 years ago because of the capital, the student capital of the division, MVC. Now they have the new name. Guess what is the name? I'll give you 100 pesos. what's the name of MVC? Movement of Victorious Canvassers. Movement of Victorious Canvassers. CPAC, SPAC, all, I have the names for all of them. I baptized them. AOP, I also baptized this more than 7 years ago. You know, AOP. Although it doesn't sound very familiar or powerful, but according to publishing, but still it is advancing, undaunted, positive. It's AOP. Advancing, undaunted, and positive. Sabagkat hindi tayo, if you are not advancing, dito lang tayo pagkatapos ng Congress, no more. If you are not undaunted, if you are not positive, sorry, you cannot be a good, successful student, let it be evangelist. So, that's the score. Opportunity for you. That's the spirit of prophecy. This is not my plan, not the plan of Sir Palaya, but it is God's plan according to spirit of prophecy. Do you believe that Ellen White is inspired by the Holy Spirit? May I see your hands? Okay, thank you. Because if not, we can be baptized tomorrow. This is from the spirit of prophecy. When school closes, there will be opportunity for many to go out into the field as evangelistic canvassers. You know, you are not an ordinary canvasser. If you are selling Avon or Tupperware, sinasabi sa iba, Tupperware, nakatapal sila, that's still selling. But when you are still in ILE, you are selling the truth-filled literature, it is an evangelistic canvassing. You know, this word canvassing is the old English used by the prophet Ellen White. Okay? Now, number one, it is a divine plan for our students. It is a divine plan, not human plan. You know? So when you go out, you will really be able to experience kayo na mga virgin pa sa literature ministry. Hindi pa nyo nasubukan na mag-dumalaw ng tao at saka na maging ili. You will really experience that it is the plan of God. The Lord has instituted a plan whereby many of our students in our schools, because if you are not joining with the plan, maybe Sir Matira will go to the LaSalle University, will go to Siliman, mga Protestante, mga Catholic, ang ating ikampanya, sapagkat ang Adventista ay wala dyan. Pero andito kayo, praise the Lord. Many of the students in our schools can learn practical lessons needful to success in afterlife. That is in the culture ministry book. Our schools have been established by the Lord. It's established by the Lord. AUP. You could have been in UB, you could have been in LaSalle or Ateneo or wherever. But this is established by the Lord. And if they are conducted in harmony, if there is, I'm glad the president is your speaker. That means showing a strong support to this Sally Club. And if it is conducted in harmony with his purpose, the youth sent to them will quickly, not slowly, quickly be prepared to engage in the various branches of missionary work. Some will be trained to enter the field as missionary nurses. Pero close na. Wala na recruiting sa, wala na hiring sa America, sa Europe ngayon. Very small na nurses, di ba? Pero dito ang malaking recruiting, canvassers. Yan. Some as evangelists, some as teachers, some as gospel ministers. So ang literature ministry, what you will be doing, is a part of God's plan according to the vision given by God to His prophet Ellen White. Pangalawa, it is a mix of education and training for students. I told you. Many things you will get in the field which you will not learn from the classroom. Here, the various education young men can obtain is by entering the canvassing field and working from house to house. Today, not only from house to house, from office to office, you know, it's there. And you know, how is this? Our beloved president of our division, he had been a student in ILE when he was in Mountain View College. And he is the son of a retired liturgy evangelist. His father was a retired Ely. So because he is trained for this, now he became the president of the division. I believe that he said his experience being a student Ely, and not only student but a regular Ely, has prepared him to be president. Karamihan naging administrator na hindi nakaranas ng experience sa literature ministry, even for 350 working hours, ay hindi masyado, sabi natin, effective ang kanilang leadership. But administrators today, if you trace their background, they have tested the experience, even for 2 months. Itong ating 2 months, 350 hours ay very short lang, Sir Madera. Have you seen Mormons? Have you seen the Mormons going two by two? And they are also bringing, also knocking at the door. They are also presenting books. You know, 2 years ang contract nila sa kanilang churches doon, where they come from. 2 years. Sa atin, 2 months. Mahirap ba yung 2 months? Sana 2 years ang sa kanila. Rain or shine, makikita mo yun sila. Diba? Nakakurbata. Ako nakakurbata because I'm facing you. Meaning, I'm facing very important people. If I'm facing people who are drunkards and drug addicts, I will not use this one. Right? Because you are doing a very important work. Okay. So, this is Pastor Golpan. Because of his experience being student ILE and even a regular literature evangelist, he is now the president of our division. It is a financial help to students and parents as they may be the large of success, degree of success financially. Some will learn lessons of thrift and economy. You know, pag kayo kumikita na sarili niyong sikap, sarili niyong pawis, napakasarap ng pera. Diba? So, you will learn how to use it wisely. Before ibili mo ng whole wheat bread, you think twice. Kailangan ba to? You know, you will learn. Kasi you earn it through prayer and hard work. Pero yung binigay, alagi hiningin natin sa mama, sa daddy, left and right ang ating spending. Hindi natin ma-feel. Diba? When I was in Bangladesh, yung napakita ko kanina, Bangladesh, only almost 100 students out of 800 students. Why? Mostly the students are sponsored. May nagbayad kanila galing sa Amerika, sa Europe. But according to the teachers, hindi masyado magandang effect ng sponsorship, sir. Wala silang missionary spirit. And mostly of the students who are receiving enough money are the problems in the dormitory. Is that so? That's possible, really? You know. So, you know, here, if you earn your own money, the Lord has given you. Ang sponsor mo ninyo ay the man from Galilee. I assure you that. When you go out with a good determination and you follow instruction and with your commitment to the Lord, the man of Galilee will sponsor for your needs, for your tuition fees, whatever. Which will be of great advantage to them when they are sent as missionaries. You see, it is a personality development. There are more difficulties in this world. Now, sasabihin natin ang mga hindi lang positive. Sabihin din natin ang mga challenges. Kaya nga lang, many will join, like majority of the college. No, hindi talaga. Kasi this is not an easy job. Calling. It is a very challenging one. There are more difficulties in this work than in some other branches of business. You see? There are more. Ang prophet ang nagsabi dito, there are more difficulties in this kind of work compared to others. But yan ang ingatan ninyo, yung but. But may but. Ha? Sa government, but. Sa akin, value added time. Pwede ba? Nagdagan pa naman ako? But the lessons learned, the time and discipline acquired will fit you for other fields of usefulness. I tell you, when you pass one summer, that is good for 1 year. Experience, actual experience. Much more. You know, meron tayong estudyante sa Mountain View College. I was touched with her story. I sure didn't like her. Her father was a literature evangelist. And his father got 10 children for the first wife. First wife. And the first wife died. And then he married another second wife. Young, 23 years old, while the man was only 44 years old. Sabi nila, old ka na ba eating yung grass? And, brother, listen to this. Another 10 children. So they are now 20. And she is one of the 20, the second batch. Second batch niya. So paano siya makatapos ng pag-aral niya? Paano siya makatapos? 10 of them sa second wife. No way. No way. Only Jesus is the way. So he said, I have to join the student union every summer vacation. Every summer. Kaya nga, ngayon, graduate siya yung coming March, magna. Kasi magna 9 years siya sa Mountain View. 9 years siya. Because wala siyang maasahan. Kanyang source lang, student union during summer vacation. I was touched and I asked Mountain View one time, sino sa inyo ang naka-experience na for 3 years? Marami. 4 years? Marami. 5 years? Naka-reduce na. 6 years? Sabi ko, 8 years? Isa na lang. And she is the one, 8 years. Wow, sabi ko, okay. I will help you. Aside from your work, every summer vacation, you receive 50% commission plus the 10% scholarship from the department. The division will sponsor you another 5% out of your sales. Because I was really touched with her experience. And, you know, in Manila, she worked 2 years ago in Manila for the first time. Alam mo ang mga Bisaya, mahirap ang Tagalog ng Bisaya. Matigas. Matigas. Yun ang accent ng South. Cannot deny the fact, regional accent. So, problema na pagpunta sa Manila, pero walang matigas sa there's no hard territory for a good student literature evangelist. One night, she was praying. She said, Lord, June is coming, and the tuition fees, I'm going to pay at least 25,000 pesos for interns. So, Lord, tomorrow, you are going to send. Guide me, where are the prospects? You know, prospects, that means, sa salesmanship, kung prospects ang pag-usapan, you must know the name at least. Who is it? Dinotan ng opisina or yung nakata do, at least you know the name of the person, Mr. Bermudez. So, pagkatok mo, pag bukas ng pinto, hello, good afternoon, is this the house of Mr. Bermudez? Huh? Why do you know me? So, at least you're aware. But if you knock at the door, and you don't know the name, whom are you looking for? Ah, si Mister? Sinong Mister? Si Sir? Sinong Sir? Walang mahirap yun. Walang kapapoint. That means, hindi yun prospect mo. When we see prospect, at least you know the name, the religion, the number of children, at least you have advanced information. Pag wala kayong advanced information, hindi yun tinatawag na prospect sa salesmanship. Tinatawag yun na suspect. At maraming suspect every day, pero walang prospect. Mahirap yung suspect. Kung minsan, ikaw pa maging suspect. Who are you? Especially if you are not dressed to sell. Hello, are you listening? If you are not dressed to sell, you will be suspected. Baka ito ang nag-rape doon. Walang masya. Walang hirap at saka, you know, ikaw ang maging suspect. Lord, tomorrow you are going to sell. So that I can help you and I can enroll this coming June. Kinabukasan po tara siya sa opisina. May prospects yan na pinagdasal niya yung office na yan. Pagpasok niya, ang lima mga employees, lahat objections. You know, objections iba-iba. Just going around the same reason. No time. Remember this. No need. No interest. Pag-apat, no money. Yun ang pinakamahirap. No money. No time, no need, no interest, no money. So, limang mga employees niya sa ban, walang bumili. So, sabi niya sa sekretary, ma'am, thank you very much. I'm going now. Pero sabi niya, Lord, yun ang pray ko kagabi, pero bakit zero ito ngayon? Pero kumins kong zero, zero, lalo na kung sa kaliwa magsimula, o sa kanan magsimula, zero, zero, maglagay din ng one, no, 10,000. So yung zero, pabayaan mo lang yan. Zero, zero. Basta sa kanan magsimula. Okay. So, sabi ng sekretary, okay, we are sorry. Untimely ang pagpunta mo dito. Parang naka-bili sa mga libro mo. Pero, miss, punta mo yung building na yan, may maliit na entrance. Pagpasok mo dyan, there is a bank. There. You go to the bank. I know the manager, Mr. Villacruz. Oh. Okay? So you know the Holy Spirit started to work. Because she prayed last night. And when she went there, to the office, she befriended the secretary, ma'am. I'd like to see Mr. Villacruz, the manager of the bank. Okay? Sir, may bisita kayo. And then she approached the manager and said, sir, so introduce yourself. I'm student from Mountain View College, very far from Mindanao. Hindi ba kayo Abu Sayyaf? Sabi ng manager, ay hindi sir. Sa Bukidnon kami, Diyan Santos, malapit kay Manny Pacquiao. Ang Abu Sayyaf na kung sa Basilan sa Puna. Malayo sir ang buwan, pero punta kito kasi may magandang mga servisyo ako para sa iyong health, para sa iyong mga anak, sa iyong misis, pakita niya mga aklat. Say, uy, sorry, sorry, don't proceed. Stop the presentation. I have no time. You can leave now. Maybe you can come back next time. Ako, kung nagpe-pray ka at saka ganun ang mangyari, human nature, you will feel discouraged, right? Anyway, she returned her books to the bag, na ang bag ay mabigat kung minsan parang na ganun na siya magdala ng bag. Mabigat. Sabi niya, sir, okay, thank you very much. I might come back anytime in the future. But before I go, I'd like to offer a prayer. Sinabi niyang prayer, tumingin ng eyes to eyes ang matir. Sabi, sir, what is your request? Do you have any request for prayer? Request for prayer. And the manager said, are you an angel? He said, sir, I'm a student from Mountain View. He said, why, sir? He said, because last night, before I went to sleep, I opened my email. And the email says, at 11:30 today, it's 11:30 before noon, an angel will come to my office. That's why I told you to evaporate, because the angel will come. But when you say that you are going to pray, oh, this must be the angel. And the student will say, that's true, sir. My work is the work of an angel. Because, you know, this book will make you, your wife and you, sweeter as the years go by. And this Bible story is for your children. You can, your money can buy almost everything except character. It's the work of an angel. I said, how many books do you have? How much? So all the books that she was bringing, the manager purchased in cash. Amen. Kasi kung minsan, kung hindi kasaba, cash yan. Kasi paano kasaba? Magali. Kung hindi kong galitan, cash yan. You know, sounds funny. And then the manager said, okay, employees, we have 10 employees here. Please, please, allow her to visit your table. And do not allow her to leave without getting something from the student. Please. Wow, she made a good sales in that office. And said a very good sales qualification. Maybe when you go out, Maybe it's not through email. God will do a miracle through you. But in many ways. Baka sabihin nyo, saan ano yung sinabi ni Pastor Bermudez na email? Kahit na signal ng wifi, wala pa nga. No. I mean, that is a miracle for that specific name, for that place and time. But God will do many more miracles in other ways. Pero hinanda yun ang Panginoon. Hinanda yun ang Panginoon. Dahil sa prayer sa gabi. So your personality will be developed, you'll become patient, you'll be more prayerful, and you know how to deal with people, your personality. It is spiritual development. As the Jews, they thought that Christ is their companion, a holy awe, a sacred joy will be felt by them. They will learn to pray as the Word. Pray and work and pray, and the Lord will work with you. That is our spiritual development. You know, we need spiritual development if we are to be ready for the coming of Jesus Christ. Because Jesus said, I will be with you. Experience this, young people. Experience this promise of the Lord that He will be with us. That is the promise to each one of us. Especially in the student program. I know, I have observed for more than 40 years now. Or you might say, Pastor, matanda ka na pala, more than secret. More than 40 years in service in the liturgy ministry. So many miracles ang nakita ko sa mga estudyante. Why? Because they are helpless. Wala siyang experience yan. Ito mga credential na hindi natin. Kahit wala nang bigas sa bahay, hindi yan natatakot. Ang mga credential na hindi natin, mga experienciado na. Because they learn. Pero ang mga estudyante, mga walang experience yan, helpless. Kaya nga doon nagpapakita din ang Panginoon ng mga himala. You know? So because he said, I will be with you. Mountain View College, you know, this is the lady na sinabi ko sa inyo na nag-works sa CLC two years ago, na experience niya ng email. Nag-email na ang angel will come at 11:30 and she was the one. You know? So, well, these are the students who came forward when we made an appeal. But you can also see that there also is the A at the back. Is the A sitting down always? Anyway, that's natural. Some students who are not joining, they might have another plan. We don't know. We cannot judge, you know. So, in Indonesia, for example, this is from Onai. We have at least more, last summer was 147 student illness in Onai. Bandung, Indonesia. You know, I closed this story before I said that, sorry, 4 o'clock. Ito ay theology student itong si Manjuntak, Jimmy Simanjuntak, sa kaliwa. They were working in North Sumatra and devotional nila is 2 hours. We applied the technicals of Mountain View College na balance ang spiritual preparation at saka ang actual work. 4 hours working, 4 hours ang devotional. 2 hours in the morning, ang devotional 8 to 10. Pagka 10 to 12, trabaho. Pagbalik, kain. Pagkatapos, devotional 1 to 2 to 3. 2 hours devotional. Pagka 3 to 6, trabaho naman. Balance. Because sometimes we are rushing so that we can visit more people, we have more sense. Pero kung minsan, ang ating spiritual preparation is lacking. You know? So ito inapin ni Jimmy Simanjuntak ang preparation niya, 2 hours preparation. So that morning, nag-attend siya ng devotional for 2 hours, may dalawa siyang prospect, hindi suspect. Pinuntan niya, isang haji, leader ng Muslim, you know, doon sa Indonesia. You know, Indonesia, 92% are Muslims. Yan, another challenge. Sa atin sa Pinas, okay, Christian. At least Pentecostal, Baptist, Catholic. They believe in God. 2 prospects. After devotional 2 hours, he went out with courage, with power and confidence. Lord, I have 2 prospects today. The other are suspects. After the 2 approaches, then I will go to knocking at doors. but the two ones I know the name, so I prayed last time. When she went to the first prospect, she was a member of the Protestant, kasi nahanap niya Protestant, kasi at least Christian. Talk niya, that was 10 o'clock in the morning. Pagbukas ng pinto, nakadala ang babae, misis ng isang balding tubig. Hello ma'am, a student of online university, I have a very important program for you. May I step in, please? Thank you. No, you can leave. I am very busy. Ma'am, just for short time. I promise you, I will not stay long. I'll be as brief as possible. You know, you have to know also your short approach. That is the technique there, mental preparation. Huwag kang mag-back out immediately. Kasi kung minsan ang objection ay pretense. You handle it. I promise you, I'll be as brief as possible if you let me in. So naglalit ka agad ng babae? Sabi niya, I told you to get away. So pinuhos yung isang balding tubig. Because he's going to water her flowers. Doon binuhos sa student ilgi. That was rebaptism. By water and by fire. Wow! Okay, you can leave now. Okay, ma'am, thank you. Bye-bye. Baba ng kanyang tunog. Bye-bye. Wow. Pag-uwi ako ngayon sa grupo, nakahiya naman, no? Bakit ako yung binyagan? I will proceed to the next prospect. Ng isang haji, leader ng Muslim. So, at 2 blocks away, pinunta niya. Muslim doon niya. Bukas ang pinto. Ang Muslim lalaki. Hello sir, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Muslim. I'm a student. Please, what happened to you? You're wet. Why are you taking your bath? And then you're Muslim. He said, Chad, I will tell you the story inside your house. He said, are you Jimmy? Are you Jimmy? He said, how do you know my name, sir? Because last night, I dream that the man Jimmy will come to my house today. Wow. He said, sir, I am the one. So, he was ushered in, brethren, and explained all the benefits of the books. He said, okay, what are not only these 5 books, where is the price list? You know, price lot ng more than 30 titles. Sabi niya, you tell your supervisor, bring all these books to me. So tomorrow, I tell you, it was heavy loaded delivery for the Muslim. All the help books available. Kaya nga, pinadala niya ang leader, yan, deliver sila. Sabi niya, sir, kahit every day, kahit may isang balde na tubig, okay lang. Basta, ang sales okay din. You know, those experiences, I tell you. Hindi ba mga miracles yan? Those are miracles. Na hindi ordinary na work ito. You know, nakikita niyo mga cute ng mga estudyante niya, ng experience nila. Nang tumanggap ng mga awardee. Kaya na, he was asking Daniel, when will be the awarding? All the students who work last summer should be given awards. You know, should be recognized. Division will help, union will help. Ibigay ka ako ng aid. Kung walang aid, kahit na bad aid na lang. Okay, so Thailand. A lot of stories, Thailand. Napakahirap sa Buddhist country, no? Pero ang experience yan, itong leader, John Tao Tao is from Davao Mission, ating leader doon sa mga itong mga estudyante sa Chiang Mai, ating academy sa Chiang Mai. Wow! Ang talagang ginagawa, nag-display. Kasi kung minsan di sila magkapasok sa mga bahay, nag-display dyan sa malapit sa mga monks. Display ang mga libro natin dyan. And then, naglagay sila din ng offering box. Kasi ang mga monks, mahiling magbigay ng offering. Offering, may libro. So, ang monks. Kasi yun ang ginagawa nila, humihingi ng offering sa mga bahay. Sa vision by works, pag nagbigay ka ng offering na malaki, malaki ang points mo. Pag nagkapatayong ka ng temple, no. 100% ang perfection mo. Yun sa Buddhism, you know. Kaya nga, ang mga monks, hindi yan nagluluto yan. Every morning, nagkukulit lang ang offering sa mga bahay. Bumibigay ang mga tao sapagkat it's a merit. It is a points for them. Kaya pag nakita nila din na may naghingi ng offering, nagbibigay din sila ng offering. Pero yung offering pa binigay nila, binibigyan ng ili natin ng mga libro na according to, you know, mga small literature. So, it is really very interesting, the work that I tell you all the stories that student ili is in Thailand, very successful. Brethren, you will have both success, just so money. Not only success. If you have money, you work outside, you work with Max, you work with Jollibee, with McDonald, and many others, you have money, you have success. But in the literature ministry, you will have good success. Not only success, but good success until you. Because you will feel the joy of serving through Jesus Christ. But you have prepared for success. How to prepare for success? Tomorrow, or if you have still time on Sunday, can give you some tips how to prepare for success. Okay? Prepare for success. Because Napoleon Hill said, he who fails to prepare, prepares to fail. So you must be ready physically, emotionally, mentally, and spiritually before you go out. And our leaders can help you. Director Matira, Director Balaya can help you on this. Okay? Shall we pray, loving Father? We thank you for this time to inspire one another about your literature ministry. This is your plan, O God, that our young people will be involved in this secret literature ministry. To bring the hope into every home, Lord, I pray, increase our faith. Help us to overcome unbelief. And bless the students who are here and those who will be attending tomorrow. Thank you, Lord, for hearing our prayer. We ask this in Jesus' powerful name. Amen. Amen.